আচ্ছা, হ্যালো এভরিওয়ান, আই উইল বি টিচিং VLSI সার্কিটস অ্যান্ড সিস্টেমস। দ্য কন্টেন্ট অফ মাই টুডেস লেকচার ইজ হোয়াট ইজ VLSI, নিড অফ VLSI, ইভলিউশন অফ VLSI চিপ অ্যান্ড ইভলিউশন অফ ট্রানজিস্টার। নাও VLSI স্ট্যান্ডস ফর ভেরি লার্জ স্কেল ইন্টিগ্রেশন, বাট ভেরি লার্জ স্কেল ইন্টিগ্রেশন অফ হোয়াট? ভেরি লার্জ স্কেল ইন্টিগ্রেশন অফ সার্কিট কম্পোনেন্টস। Now VLSI is a technology which actually helps the electronics engineer to fabricate microchips or nanochips. Now in VLSI chip, not only digital circuits, ROM, RAM, CPU, different logical functions can be incorporated on a single chip. VLSI technology came into picture in the year of 1970, when actually the requirement of fabricating CPU chip or CPU processor came in the market. Now my next topic is need of VLSI. Main need of VLSI is basically miniaturization of all electronic components. We can see that we are using cell phone, a single device using which we can make a call, we can listen to different songs, we can see the video. So all the different functions are incorporated on this small device. Actually, all the different functions means different circuits. So lots of circuits are incorporated on single chip. And what is the size of the mobile phone? This is the size of a mobile phone with which we can actually perform different functions. Now, as for example, we can consider the first hard drive. The size of that hard drive was 2.5 GB and the actual size of it was like a refrigerator and it weighed 250 kilogram. But nowadays we use a SD card of few MG milligram weight and which can store 1 terabyte data. Now first IC that was designed in the year of 1961, which incorporates only 2 transistors, but nowadays the processor which are using that can incorporate trillions, millions of transistors. So we can understand the need of VLSI technology. So here you can see there is 2 pictures. First one is the first IC which was developed or fabricated by Jack Kilby in Texas Instrument Lab, and that was a 2 transistor circuit. And the second one you can see, that is a Pentium 4 processor which can incorporate or which had incorporated millions of transistors. Next, my topic is what is evolution or how the VLSI technology has evolved. Almost more than 100 years ago, first semiconductor device was fabricated in the year of 1904, and that was nothing but a point contact metal semiconductor diode, and that was patented by an US officer, and he was the person behind IC technology or VLSI technology. He has first fabricated 2 transistor IC. He is Jack Kilby from Texas Instruments. Next, history of VLSI. In late 40s means 1940s, first IC was fabricated in Bell Lab, which has incorporated only 1 transistor. Then in late 50s, it has incorporated 2 transistors, a flip-flop. Then early 60s, it has incorporated more than 10 transistors, that is basically small scale integration. In late 60s, more than 100 transistor was fabricated, that is medium scale integration. After that, in this way, nowadays we can incorporate more than 10,000 or billions transistors. So we are in the age of ULSI, that means ultra large scale integration. Though from VLSI to ultra large scale integration, all are termed as VLSI technology. Next, evolution of transistor. Now VLSI means we are fabricating all the different functions on a chip, Functions means we have to design all the functions using only circuits. And circuit means different circuit components are there, resistance, inductor, capacitor. All these circuits are designed using only MOSFETs. So on the IC, there is only MOSFET, metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. But first transistor was designed in the year of 1925, and that was a field effect transistor. After that, in Bell Lab, transistor was designed by William Shockley and his co-workers. Then Morris Tannenbaum first designed transistor or fabricate transistor on the semiconductor substrate. After that, MOSFET come into the picture, and then evolution of MOSFETs. Nowadays, research is going on MOSFET and miniaturization of the size of the MOSFET. So VLSI circuits means we have to design all the different components using only MOSFET. So it is having two parts, one digital IC design, another part is analog IC design. In digital IC design, all the different digital circuits will be designed using MOSFET, and in analog IC design, all the different analog circuits will be designed in using only MOSFET. In my next class, I will discuss about different types of MOSFET, PMOS, NMOS and CMOS. Okay, thank you.